My name is Pam Cortese, and along with my husband and our children, we run a store in California called The Place That Sells Sewing Machines. The philosophy of our store has always been that we put the fun back into your sewing. And I know a lot of you out there are just not having any fun with your sewing machines. So what can I teach you? Well, let me tell you a little bit about myself. When my husband and I opened up our business, I hated to sew. Every time I sewed, something happened wrong. I broke thread, I broke needles, the stitching was lousy. I wasn't having any fun. I basically was in the business and I did all the repairs in the sewing machine store. My husband, bless his heart, gave all the instruction. He taught our sewers how to make buttonholes and how to thread their machine and wind their bobbins. I fixed them. I didn't want to sew. After years of being a very, very good mechanic, I'm very proud of that, I realized that most of the people that sew don't understand the mechanical workings of a machine. And so they were fighting against these mechanical monsters all the time. And of course, they weren't having any fun. That's about when I decided I'm going to make a video. I'm going to help you out. You've got a mechanical machine. Maybe you bought it from a store that doesn't give classes, doesn't give instruction. Maybe you bought it from a mass merchandiser. Maybe it was inherited. Maybe it was one that you've got years and years ago when you got married. You haven't used it for 20 or 30 years. Usually you've lost the book, and the books don't help that much anyway. I find a human can really shortcut and make short work of all this information. So what I want to accomplish in this video is I want you to understand your mechanical machine, to learn to do things that you didn't know that you could do. I'll show you a few tricks and tips. And I basically want to make your sewing more fun, because at The Place That Sells Sewing Machines, we put the fun back in your sewing. The first thing that we need to do today is to figure out what kind of mechanical machine you have. I have a bunch of mechanical machines here, but they are all slightly different. Now, this is an older machine, and you probably got one in your closet. Weighs about 80, 90 pounds, and they called it portable. It's a basic zigzag machine. It is a front rotary tension. You'll learn more about tensions in a second. This is a front rotary. This is a side load machine. It has a bobbin in a bobbin case. It's called a vertical bobbin. There is another machine very similar, another style of mechanical machine. And instead of this slide plate moving out this direction, it actually moves towards the front. That's called a front loader. Okay, so you've got a rotary tension, a front load. You could have a rotary tension or a side load. Because this is an older machine, it also has an exterior belt. This is a little bit newer machine. In fact, it's a brand new machine. The tension is here. It's not a rotary that's on the front. This is called a lay-in tension. It's quite a bit easier to use. In addition, this machine is a free arm. Basically, this arm is made so that you can slip a sleeve or a pant leg over the arm and sew kind of in a circular motion. It's a lot easier. And actually, in my store, I don't sell any of the old flatbeds anymore. This is another free arm machine. It's different from the second machine I showed you in that the tension is a rotary tension. It's a little bit closer to the machine than the first one that we saw, but it's still a rotary tension, and we'll go more into that later. Now, I know a lot of you have this machine lurking in your closet, or maybe you've sewn on one in the past, a very popular older model. It's a flatbed. It's a rotary tension, but this is different than the other ones I showed you because it has a front load drop-in bobbin. So basically, your bobbin just drops inside. In this section, we're going to learn the proper name for each part of your sewing machine. There's not a day that goes by at my store that someone doesn't come in or call me and try to describe, well, this little dealy bopper and this little gizmo.